So I've been trying to live stream, but I can't find a streaming service that allows me to. I've tried streaming on YouTube, but YouTube says I'm not eligible to stream, and I don't want to go to Twitch because I don't like the color purple. So the next best solution was to create my own live streaming service, and what better place to create a live streaming service than on Scratch? That's right, I am going to be live streaming on Scratch. If you don't know what Scratch is a basic programming language used to teach kids how to program. So if we want to live stream on Scratch, we need to understand how a live stream works. In a live stream, the streamer is playing a game or reacting to something. The viewers are watching the live streamer and is able to chat to the streamer using a chat system. So first we code in our game for the streamer. The game I chose to live stream was Flappy Bird. Flappy Bird is a pretty simple game to program. The game is so easy to program, I could give you a tutorial right now. So first, we're gonna create our bird placeholder. Next, we're gonna create some pipe placeholders, and then we add some code to those placeholders, and boom, we're already finished with the game. Just look at that placeholder flapping away.
But how exactly do I live stream this? How do I display this Flappy Bird game onto a different viewer's screen?
Well, we have to use something called cloud variables. Cloud variables are variables stored on Scratch's servers. These cloud variables stay the same for everyone on that project, meaning we could put the streamer screen into that cloud variable and the viewer should be able to see that screen. So how do we actually code that?
Well, all we need to do is watch Griffpatch's Scratch multiplayer tutorial and
it's already on other players' screens. So basically, we're just storing the XY values of every object in the game from the streamer's project, and then we store those XY values into the cloud variable. And from the viewer's side, they just take those XY variables from the cloud variable, and then they just project it onto the viewer's screen. Now this is cool seeing the streamer's game, but I'm a viewer and I want to interact with the stream. Well, now you can with something called a chat. In a regular live stream, you would be able to type out words in the chat, but creating a chat system is actually against Scratch TOS, since there wouldn't be a way to moderate what people are typing, and this is a kid's website. So instead, I put the chat on emotes only. And what better emotes to use than Clash Royale emotes? So we're gonna use the same process that is used to transfer the streamer's game to the viewer screens to recreate the chat. So after rewatching Griffpatch's Scratch multiplayer tutorial, we could just code it so that—
wow, look, I can already type in chat now.
So to type in chat, you have to press the type in chat button and then select which emote you want. So this is done by assigning each viewer with a cloud variable, and whatever they type in chat is then stored into that cloud variable, and then other viewers just collect that data from your cloud variable and they display it into their own chat, and the streamer can also see the chat as well. Now there's actually an issue with this method. Each viewer needs to be assigned their own cloud variable for this method to work, but Scratch only allows you to have 10 cloud variables per project. This limit was added so people don't destroy the Scratch servers with unlimited cloud variables. One of these cloud variables is already used by the streamer, so we only have 9 cloud variables, which means that only 9 viewers can be typing in the chat at the same time. This is okay if you have less than 9 viewers, but what if you make it big on Scratch's live streaming service? What if you have more than 9 viewers?
I couldn't find any tutorials online on how to add more viewers to the stream. So what did you do?
Well, I just stole some code. Griffpatch, who created the Scratch multiplayer tutorial that I watched, has uploaded a Scratch project called Cloud MMO. This is a multiplayer platformer where you speedrun a course while watching other players speedrun the course at the same time. The thing about this project is that there are more than 10 players online. So did Griffpatch hack this project to have more than 10 cloud variables? Well, looking inside the project, Griffpatch has coded it in a way where you could have infinite players online. So instead of assigning each player with their own cloud variable, each player puts their data into a random cloud variable. This makes it so that there will always be 10 random players stored into the cloud variables, and all the players take the data from the cloud variables and then display it onto their own screens.
And now we're able to have infinite people typing in our chat and infinite viewers on our live stream.
Technically, we're able to have infinite viewers online, but the viewer count would break. Scratch has added a 0.1 second delay on cloud variables before they get updated. This is to make sure people don't destroy the Scratch servers by spamming the cloud variables.
Again,
with only 9 cloud variables and 10 viewers per cloud variable per second, the live stream can only process 90 viewers per second. I coded it so the live stream only checks if a viewer is still online every 10 seconds, so the viewer count can only go up to a max of 900 viewers in a 10 second frame. This also goes for our chat. Doing the math, we can only process 90 messages per second. So if we add thousands of messages in chat, we can only process 90 of those messages per second. Now, we're able to get away with a broken chat and viewer count because it really wouldn't matter. It's just a number in the top right corner and emotes in a chat. But I would still like to give a RIP to the people in chat whose emotes didn't go through. And now we have a working chat. We're basically almost done creating a live stream. It's really that easy. This is how Twitch was created. We just need to do a couple of things, like create the actual sprites for the Flappy Bird game. That's a very pretty bird. We also need some sound. I was too lazy to get the actual Flappy Bird sound effect, so I just looked through the stock sound effect library that Scratch had. I also added a live viewer count that I'm actually proud of for coding in myself. Look, I have one viewer. And now we can live stream on Scratch. Huh?
Ben?
Oh yeah, we also have Ben. Except it's just a worse version of him. Could you tell I created all the assets? Now in the original Ben game, you would talk to Ben, and then he would speak back to you. But Scratch doesn't give you an option to put a mic input, so I just made a button for Ben to talk. This also means Ben can't repeat back what you say to him. But it's still good to have Ben. And now, we can finally live stream on Scratch.
So this is Flappy Bird. Here's some Flappy Bird gameplay.
Yeah, I don't know what you're expecting. I don't know why, but I put the death sound effect on everything. It's probably because I was lazy. Yeah, it gets annoying quick.
I don't know why, but Flappy Bird is just not smooth on the viewer's end. This is the viewer screen, and it's consistently dropping frames. I don't know if my code is bad or this is a problem with the Scratch servers, but it's just dropping frames.
Oh, I forgot to mention that I created a home screen for the streamer. I know, the app logos look so official. Also, you can see the streamer's mouse on the viewer side with this unnecessarily large cursor.
The next and last game that we have is Ben, and it has no issues, right, Ben?
Yes.
Should the viewer subscribe right now, Ben?
Yes.
You heard, Ben. Oh, and that's the chat system. The chat system is smooth and you can spam emotes. Just please shut up while I'm talking.
Now that I think about it, I should have added a ban feature. Now I've tested the live stream with only one viewer and it does seem to work, but I haven't tested any bigger than that because I don't have any friends. Shut up, Ben. But I might try and get your guys' help to test how many viewers this live stream can handle in the future.
In conclusion, live streaming is 100% possible on Scratch, and I believe streamers should leave their streaming services and switch right over to Scratch.
Now I could add more emotes, more games for the streamer, or other live streaming features such as donations,
but those are some features I could add in the future. If you guys want to see more of live streaming on Scratch, please like the video.
Anyways,
subscribe to Mr. Sir.